ない主義なので。残業は嫌いなので手早く済ませましょう。
The voice, my god. But anyways, welcome back again, people, to another Jump Assemble video. For today, we're gonna be discussing and also gonna be explaining the skills of Nanami and also maybe some combos and some item tips for you all. And let's just jump right into it. This year is like very, very basic, but we'll see. It's like basic, but at the same time, very difficult to execute. So let's go. So here we are now on the training area, and of course, we'll be showing first Nanami's basic attack. So this is his basic attack. So that's his basic attack. Now let's go first for the passive. Oh, by the way, I forgot. Here's some skill description if you want. Just pause and read it if you want. So here's the skill description of passive. First skill, second skill, third skill, and then the fourth skill. So first let's go to the passive. So passive, basically, just like it said here, Nanami will deal 125 critical damage to enemy targets, and all of the critical things or the all of the critical chances that he will get for, out of items will be converted into a physical damage. So basically, Nanami will not deal a critical damage, but all of the critical chances that you are gonna get from items or by levels will be converted into a 2.5 physical attack. So I think you already have an idea of what items I'm gonna be giving in the end of the video. But first, yeah, let's go for the first skill. That's the passive skill. Let's go for the first skill. It is just basically a fan shaped area that will deal a damage, and also it will give you a regen or like a spell vamp. Let me show it to you. Okay, so that's the first skill. Inumaki is chasing us, but this is the first skill. There you have a 402 spell vamp. And the thing about first skill is, the more farther you are, or the more the enemy is farther in the range, the more it deals damage. Let's say, for example, the enemy is within this like first layer of the sea or the half moon. You will only deal the damage of 521. But if the enemy is in this line, in this second line or the third line of the letter C or the wide range, you will deal 622 damage. So it's like the farther you are, the more damage you will deal. This is like the idea of Nanami's skill. That is why I've said his skills is very easy, but the way you execute it, or the way you utilize it, the way you utilize the damage is a much more difficult than you ever thought about it. So again, first skill is just this one. You can also move during this phase, but the farther the enemy is, the more you deal damage. Again, the nearer deals 521, but if it is in the second line or this third line, you will deal 622 damage. So that's the first skill. Second skill is a dash. You can use this to pass through walls, and also it will deal damage. And again, this damage has like these specific hitboxes. So if the enemy will gonna be hit by this one, the nearer, it will deal 321 damage, but the farther you are, it deals 384 damage. And also, the second skill has two phases. So let's say, for example, you successfully hit an enemy with your second skill, you will also have another second skill for 4 seconds. Again, the farther you are of the enemy of the Nanami skill, the more the damage it will deal. So for comparison again, 321, but in this other box, 384. So that's Nanami's second skill. For the third skill, it is a knockback, and that is all. It will deal a damage also, a knockback, and it will deal damage. And then the only like catch about the third skill is, after 10 minutes in game or in the battle, this will change it to, instead of kicking back, Nanami will gonna punch the enemy. He will also deal a lot more damage, and also still has a knockback. So after 10 minutes, instead of kicking, you will punch the enemy. Maybe we can reach at the 10 minutes and I will show it to you. But also I have another clip where I reach 10 minutes and the third skill changes from kicking to punching. Now the ultimate skill is, if you activate this, all of your first to third skill will be disabled, and also you cannot do a basic attack. But in turn, you will deal a 4 like dash with damage. It's like second skill, but I think it's much more longer. So I'll just gonna show it to you. This is the ulti. So you cannot do basic attack in this stage. Look at your first skill and third skill. It is also disabled. But you will have this 4 stacks of the ultimate. And you will have this. It's the same with your second skill. But again, the catch, the farther you are to the enemy, the more you deal damage. Say for example, you will have this 556, but if you're farther, 667. And also, if you have I still don't know how you can get it, but you will get a black flash thingy if you have a specific timings of your skill. I think you need to let the enemy be in the between. So you will deal a black flash. There! You will deal a black flash. That's the black flash. That is another additional damage. So it's like you have a 3 damage for the ulti. The near one. Oh, you will still also deal black flash. And then the farther one. And then the black flash, which deals another more damage. So basically, that's all of the enemy's skill. Very easy to understand. Now how about the what spell are you gonna use? Of course, he is labeled as assassin, so you will gonna be doing this one, retribution or the jungle spell. But I can also see Nanami as a XP laner, in which you can use enfeeble or maybe berserk or strong. You can go for that options. Or I can also see Nanami as a support, a jungler support or an invader support or invader roamer, whatever you call it, but damage dealer support or damage dealer roamer. I can also see him, he also have that chance of being that one because of this knockback, and also you can do this very pretty long range of the skill to the enemies, so it has a chance of doing that. So that is the idea that I have as of the moment. You can go for assassin or jungler, a XP laner or a damage roamer. Now for the items, just like I've said, Nanami's passive is every time you have a 1% of your crit chance can be converted into a 2.5 physical attack. That is a very very big one. So I highly suggest you will prioritize itemizing items that has critical damage. And that would be, you can go for this one, reduce cooldown, or for this one, or for this one. I would rather go for this one because I love the cooldown. And then next is, of course, go get this one. And then my idea is to get this. It has critical chance. And after critical hit, basic attack damage is increased by 20%. So every time you deal critical damage, although Nanami cannot deal a critical hit, the most important thing here is just to get the 25% crit chance. Get this one, Blade of Phantom, which the passive is every time you do a spell or a skill, your basic attack will be enhanced. And what other else? I think you can also go for this one, Red Skill Knife. It doesn't have any critical chance, but you have a cooldown reduction and then layering of your skills. So basically, the idea of this one is it will increase your skill damage. And also, that's it. It will increase your skill damage, and also you have a sight range for the next basic attack. You will deal extra damage to the enemy if you are out of the sight of the enemy. And then the last one, you can go for either Millennium or go for this one, Judgment Sword. It also has a crit chance. So let's see for how much we're gonna deal to Inumaki. Two hits to the enemy Inumaki. That's a very very high damage. So that's a full burst. You can also go for a tanky build, but I rather highly suggest you'll go for a full burst and Just prioritize critical chances items. So go for this. You can experiment. You can remove this, and you can remove this Beidou Phantom or this one. Just change this to maybe this one. I'll go for this one. It also has critical chance, I think. Yes, it also has critical chance. You can remove this red skill and change this into Weapon of God's Mysterious, or maybe this one. Change this Weapon's God's Mysterious. It's up to your preference. But the key note is just to have a item that has critical chance, so you will increase your damage. And lastly, the combo. Oh, here it is, the activation of the third skill, because it is 10 minutes. Let's go click it. There it is. Nanami will tie his necktie on his arms, and he will punch the enemy instead of kicking. There, and it will deal more damage, which is very nice. Now for the combo. The thing that I have think about or invented something of a combo is you go for your second skill first, and then you kick back, and then you second skill, first skill, ultimate, and then go for that one. Just spam your ulti. The idea is, as much as possible, you want to hit the enemy. You want to hit your second skill the farther the enemy is, or just hit your second skill. Just try your best to make your second skill hit farther, so you will deal more damage. So second skill, and then the idea of the kickback is you have to have this range again, so you will deal another damage of the second skill. And then the first skill, because there are chances that the enemy will come closer to you or will gonna run, and then you will go for the ulti for maybe chasing down the enemies, or just spamming, just finishing off the enemy. So that's my basic combo for Nanami, or basic idea for it. So again, your second skill, kickback, second skill, first skill, ulti, and then spam the ulti, and then do basic attack. And that is all. That's the basic idea of my combo. You can invent your own. It's up to you now, but I just give you the idea just to fully utilize all of the skills, just to fully incorporate all of the skills, because I really like comboing skills, or I really like fully utilizing or fully using my skills that way. So yeah, so no skills wasted, no damage wasted for that combo. And I think that is it for this video. Hope you understand. I tried my best to make it very simpler and very digestible for you all, but I hope that's helped. And that is it for this video. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, share, and subscribe. And thanks for watching. See you in the next video, where I'll gonna be showing Inumaki next, explaining skills of Inumaki. I like Inumaki. I think he's a fun support as of the moment in Jump Assemble. So that is it. Bye.